Look, Cog, look! Climate change is in the news. Floods, droughts, melting ice caps and glaciers. Instead of ignoring it, let's talk about it. Disclaimer, viewers may experience cleared neuronal circuits, increased fatty sheaths, and vigorous synaptic formations. This product is especially beneficial for patients currently experiencing eco-anxiety or head-in-sand-itis. The first thing we need to talk about is CO2. What is it? First, it's a molecule. Molecules are made of two or more atoms bonded together. The atoms we'll talk most about are carbon atoms, oxygen atoms, and hydrogen atoms. Each carbon atom makes four bonds, as if each atom had four hands to grasp other atoms. Each oxygen atom makes two bonds, as if it had two hands to grasp. And let's not forget hydrogen atoms. They make one bond, with just one hand to grasp. Now we're ready to make molecules. Let's start with carbon dioxide. We'll need one carbon and two oxygens. Its full name is carbon dioxide, but I'll mostly call it CO2 for short. Sometimes I'll draw it like this. Oxygen gas plays a big role. Oxygen travels in pairs, like this. I might call it O2, or I might draw it like this. And who doesn't love water? One oxygen and two hydrogens. I might call it H2O or draw it like this, but it's still just water. Let's look at methane gas. It's made of one carbon and four hydrogens. Methane is the smallest hydrocarbon. Hydrocarbons are molecules made only of carbon and hydrogen, like this one. They can get really long or really complicated in fossil fuels. Okay, let's take one final look at the stars of our show. This time, without those ridiculous hands. Carbon dioxide, oxygen, water, and methane. Okay, the second thing you need to know about CO2 is that it's an invisible, odorless gas. It's easy to make in your kitchen. Baking soda plus vinegar react to make CO2 gas, water, and sodium acetate, a dissolved solid. Try this. Air won't put out a flame, but CO2 does. Let's see. Baking soda, vinegar. See all those bubbles? CO2. Now pour the newly made CO2 into a clean glass. Pour the CO2 on the flame. It goes out. We didn't see the CO2, but we saw it put out the flame. Note. Just because CO2 is invisible and odorless, it is not nothing. Gases also have volume and they weigh something too. A pound of CO2, almost a half a kilogram, would fill a beach ball about 30 inches or 77 centimeters wide. A ton of CO2, the same weight as a walrus, would fill a beach ball 32 feet high. That's almost 10 meters high. Third, CO2 is a special kind of gas called a greenhouse gas. Water is a greenhouse gas. We don't worry too much about it because water doesn't accumulate in the atmosphere due to the water cycle. It goes up as evaporation, forms a cloud as condensation, and falls down as precipitation. Yes, it does. Another important greenhouse gas is methane, CH4. It's actually a more powerful greenhouse gas than CO2, but it only lasts a few decades in the atmosphere, and there's a lot less of it up there. So we'll be talking a lot about CO2. Once we put it in the air, it stays around for 100 years or more, and we've put a lot more CO2 into our atmosphere than methane. Now, here's how greenhouse gases work. Imagine three identical Earths with three identical suns. The first Earth has no greenhouse gases. High-energy light from the sun hits this Earth. Some reflects back to space, but some is absorbed by the Earth and transformed into heat that is re-radiated. Without greenhouse gases to slow it down, that heat gets lost in space. This Earth is a frozen rock where life cannot exist. In the second scenario, the sun still sends high-energy light to Earth, but this Earth has greenhouse gases in its atmosphere. The high-energy light from the sun can pass right through them. The difference in this Earth, though, is that the energy that was absorbed and re-radiated as heat cannot pass back through the gases. If heat hits a greenhouse gas molecule, it gets bounced around. It sticks around longer, so less heat gets lost in space. The Earth warms up. Greenhouse gases work kind of like the windshield of your car. Let's say you drive your car to the scene of a mutant bug invasion. After you dash off to save the world, high energy light passes through your car's windshield. The part that gets absorbed by your car's interior transforms into heat that can't easily pass back out through the windshield. When you return, covered in mutant bug snot, you open the car door, hop in, and your car is so hot, you better drive home with your windows down. Now let's look at that third Earth. It has a lot of extra greenhouse gases, lots of extra CO2. As before, the high energy light passes through the greenhouse gases. Some reflects back, but now the part that gets absorbed and re-radiated as heat is much more likely to run into a greenhouse gas molecule. Even less heat gets lost in space. Right, I know, Cog, three times. I won't say it again. But more heat sticks around longer. Earth heats up. Let's go back and look at Earth, too. Thanks to greenhouse gases, it's warm enough for liquid water and therefore life. That third Earth is where we're living now. All that extra CO2 doesn't mean that all of our days will be hot. We'll still have weather, even extreme weather. Let's not confuse weather with climate. Weather is local and temporary. It's what you see when you look out the window. Weather tells you what to wear that day, when to take an umbrella. Climate, on the other hand, is the long-term average of weather over many years, like 30 years. It tells you what kind of clothes you need to have in your closet. How cold are your winters? How hot are your summers? Climate might be saying you need a hoodie, but it won't tell you which one to buy. Okay, let's recap. CO2 is a molecule made of atoms. It's an invisible, odorless gas. It's a greenhouse gas that captures heat. And extra greenhouse gases will affect our weather and our climate. We'll talk about that as we answer more questions about CO2 in later episodes. We'll ask, where does CO2 come from? What does CO2 go into? Why is CO2 a problem? How can we limit climate change? Let's start at the top of our list. CO2 comes from lots of places, Cog. For example, did you know that CO2 comes out of our